Hey everybody, this is Kama Sweets. I'm coming to you with something that I keep getting requested about. I'm doing it on YouTube now, so everybody can always go back and watch it, because I don't know how to work Catch Me and I Periscope. Y'all know I just jump on Periscope right quick, real quick, and then I'm off, and it's up for only 24 hours and then it's gone again. And Divine Baking Divas on Facebook, we're constantly getting new members, so a lot of them don't really know what it is. And I get asked, can I do another video because I can't find it, etc., etc. So now I'm going to do the YouTube video. So basically, you can always go back to this video whenever you need it. And yeah, so one day I was sitting around and I needed to infuse some strawberries. I searched YouTube. I searched at Google, everywhere, on how to fill up my pipettes. Okay, so the first method was, of course, put the liquid inside of a cup. You know, keep squeezing until you get it as filled as you can. Wasn't working for me. Too much time. The second one was to take another pipette and to fill it up using another pipette. So you would squeeze it from the cup and you'll put it in here. Too much time. The third method was the syringe. Oh, you suck it up on the syringe and you take this and you just fill it up and keep going. Once again, too much time for me. I don't have time. I don't got time. Everybody know that I'm busy. I don't got time to waste like that. So I came up with the water bottle method. Ask me how. I just did. I came up with it. So yes, I, Kama Sweets, am the person who came up with the water bottle method on how to fill your pipettes completely filled, saving you so much time. You probably can fill 20 pipettes, 30 pipettes in about 5 minutes. I'm serious. That's how fast it is. Okay, so let's get started. Of course, what you need is your pipettes. Pipette. This is just the pipette that I like to use with the slim, narrow stem. It just helps keep the liquid in. It's, you know, it just helps keep the liquid in better to me. I do order my pipettes by a case of 5,000 from the Lab Depot. It runs me about $40-some-odd. Like I said, that might be cheaper, but I ordered it overnight, so most of that charge was overnight shipment. So they're cheaper than that. So this is the SKU number that you will use when you order from the Lab Depot. You order your pipettes. If you're on Divine Baking Divas Facebook page and you're a member, we have a member, but her name is Unique Parties. She does amazing parties. That's my girl. Does amazing parties. She also sells cute pipettes, like hearts and stars and stuff like that. So when she get them in stock, she lets us know and we order them from her. So if you want to get a little jazzy on your infusions, contact her. You can find her on Facebook, Unique Parties. She's based out of New York and she is a Divine Baking Diva. And everybody, if you do sweets and everything, cakes, you want to learn how to do more, and you're a positive person, and you're willing to learn, and you're willing to share, please, please, please join Divine Baking Divas. Miss Rochelle is the bomb. Everybody in the group is uplifting, inspiring. Doesn't matter if you're not the best. When I say they want to see you do the best, they will give you tips, everything. That this group is amazing. So, y'all, so shout out to everybody in Divine Baking Divas. I love y'all. Y'all know I love y'all. Okay, so let's get into the pipettes. So, first, you're going to get your pipettes. See, they come with a long stem like this. I don't like my stem this long. So, I get a pair of scissors, of course, and I cut it at an angle until I get it like this. And this just shorten them. You know, when you stick them in the strawberries, you really don't want them to come out the other side. So you're gonna cut your pipette stem to look like this. So it's like a little, I got a little arrow look to it. Okay, so you got your pipettes. So you got your pipettes. Boom. You got them all laid out. You got them cut. You got your everything done. Everything that you want to infuse, or you can do them ahead of time if you want, whichever you prefer. Next, you're gonna need the famous water bottle. There's no specifics on which one you need to have. Zephyr Hills, Aquafina. It just needs to have like a that plastic top, you know, one that's kind of like flexible. If you got that hard soda top, no, that ain't gonna work. Mm-mm. You need to have like a water bottle that has this little plastic flexible top. Okay, next, you're going to create a hole in your water bottle top. See that hole? This is a very, very tiny hole. You do not want to make this hole with a pair of scissors. You do not want to make this hole with a knife. Because if you make it with a pair of scissors, instead of creating a circle hole, you're going to create a slit. It's going to be like a slit. And when you turn your water bottle upside down, it's, liquid's going to go everywhere. It's going to become messy. So you want to kind of create your hole to be a small hole, but a good size. Because this is what you want to happen. You want to be able to fit your pipette directly into the hole. It needs to be a snug fit. It needs to be a little bit of tension on it. So sometimes you'll have to wiggle it a little bit. But I promise you that wiggle will still save you so much time from squeezing it out of a cup, out of a syringe, all that. It's going to save you so much time. So this is what you want it to look like. You want to be able to fit your pipette directly into the hole. Remember, depending on the size of your pipette, the stem is how big you're going to make your hole. At the end of the day, you want your pipette to fit snug into the hole. Okay, so you have a water bottle. I have two water bottles here, so I'm just going to tell y'all how versatile this is. You have water bottles here. This one could be strawberry. This can be blueberry. It's water, and I'm just giving y'all an example. Strawberry and blueberry. Okay, somebody wants a strawberry. So you just take the top, that same top that you use, tighten it onto the water bottle, and stick your pipette in it. Boom, your pipette's in it. Make sure it's tight on, because sometimes the water will seep out the side. You're going to flip your water bottle upside down. Give it one squeeze. See, it's already halfway filled. Give it a second squeeze. Flip back over, pop it out. You have a completely filled pipette. I'm talking about completely filled with the liquid. You see, it's not going to come out. Okay, so now somebody wants blueberry. We're going to take that same top that we used, and we're just going to place it, you know, rinse it out, be sanitary, rinse it out, whatever. And we're going to pop it onto blueberry. We're going to make sure that the top is on tight. And we're going to get another pipette, and we're going to pop it in the top again. We're going to flip it over. We're going to squeeze one time. And then we're going to squeeze another time. Once again, we have another filled pipette. Just tell you how fast. Look. Oh, that's, that was already filled. One. I'm gonna show y'all exactly how fast this is. I'm just putting out the water. So I'm gonna show y'all how fast it is. So y'all got that right. Hopefully y'all got it. If not, y'all hit me up on Facebook asking me questions. But I'm gonna show you how fast it is. This is one pipette. One, two. One, two. I have three filled pipettes in less than 30 seconds. Three filled pipettes in less than 30 seconds. Using what I've come up with is called the water bottle method. This is the water bottle method. Okay, so y'all remember. Put the little, you want to make sure that the hole in the top is big enough but small enough to where your where your pipette fits pretty snug and water does not seep out of it, out of the sides. Because if there's air, then the water's going to seep out of the sides of the hole. So, once again, you're going to put your hole in the top. See the hole? Put the hole in the top. This top, you can just have different water bottles and have one top. I actually have like three because when I do the decorative pipettes, I don't have them in here with me now to show you. But when I do the decorative pipettes, the bottom of those are a little bit fatter, so I have to make a bigger hole. If I get the ones from Michael's, those have a fatter stem as well, so I have to make one for those. In the meantime, though, these are the main ones that I use, so I use my one top. And that's it. I just have different water bottles that I put different things in. Clear will go in one, dark will go in one, wine will go in one, a fruit flavor will go in another one, because you can actually put like strawberry syrup, chocolate syrup in these and infuse your cupcakes with them and things like that. But I'm gonna show y'all again. You have your hole at the top made with anything from, I usually use a corkscrew, like that tip of the corkscrew, and I just punch a little hole in it and kind of twist it just a little bit to spread the hole a little bit, and that's it. That's all I do. You can do it that way. This one I made with like the tip of this, so I just took it and I just pressed it down just a little bit in there and twisted it, and that was it. I didn't push it all the way in. If you push it all the way in, you're going to create a big old hole, and you're going to have stuff going everywhere. It's not going to work. So you got to make sure you just create a little hole. I promise y'all this is not hard to do. I promise you it's not hard to do. Once you got your hole going, just pop your top back on your, pop your top on whatever flavor in your water bottle you want, and pop in your, and squeeze once, squeeze two times, fill pipette, go to the next one. Now listen, you flip it over, and squeeze and fill it up. When you go to take it out, you need to flip it right back over. If not, see that? You can't do that. So you have to flip it so it's like this. So if you see me flipping over, you go like this, and I flip it right back over to pull it out. And I promise y'all to be doing this like this. And once you get a hang of it, you're gonna be doing it like this. You're gonna be filling up pipettes like nothing. So yeah, I'm gonna leave all my information down at the bottom. Y'all get at me if you have any questions. I'll be doing probably more YouTube, especially on some other stuff, some other little tricks that I do. But yes, I am Kama Sweets. My business name is Kama Sweets and Events. I put all that information at the bottom. And y'all have any questions, y'all can inbox me anytime, email me anytime, questions regarding this method. And it's a simple method, it will save you so much money, because everybody drinks water, everybody buys a water bottle at some point. And if you have some laying around, rinse them out really good, get your top, put a hole in them, pop your pipettes in it, and then you can just store them to the side. And those will just be for when you use them. But, shout outs to DBD, Divine Bacon Divas of Facebook. I love y'all. Y'all here making noise everywhere. I'm talking about we got members that was on Cupcake Wars. We got people that be on the news. We do community events. I know they had the Easter basket assemble up in New York. We have our first convention in June in Atlanta, Georgia. Hey, it's a great community to be a part of. If you come into the group, please be active. Let us know who you are. Let us know what you want to learn. Just, don't sit back and look, because the more active you are in the group, the more you will learn. There are a lot of people that just do sit there and watch, but if you are active in it, you will learn. Everybody's throwing up periscopes. Most of the time it's free classes, not charging for any classes. It's free classes, things like that. So y'all come join us. Come look us up if you are cake bakers, if you do candy apples, because I do candy apples too. If you do strawberries, if you do parties and balloons, because I do parties and balloons as well, and that's going to be like some more of my YouTube videos, especially because I need to do one on the hardware so everybody can get that and see that on the hardware that you need in order to build your balloon columns yourself and save yourself some money. So that'll be coming next. And yeah, so I'll be leaving all the information below. You have any questions, concerns, or anything, y'all email me. My Facebook information will be down. My Instagram information will be down below. And hopefully I know this will help y'all. Because everybody right now love this water bottle method. Like, they love it. So, nice meeting y'all. Now y'all see who came up with that method. And I just thought that it was just something that everybody needed to know, because I was just seeing too many people struggled on it. And I just thought, like, people really needed to know it, because I know that some stuff that I struggle with, I've been needing to know. And Divine Baking Divas has given me so much information. Helped me so much. I thank them so much. Thank you so much, Miss Rochelle, for this group. It's amazing. Thank God for you. Yeah, so y'all hit me up on Facebook, Instagram, Miss Comma Sweets. I'll have that information below. And leave comments, like the video, things like that. Let's get this thing moving. Let's get it around. Let's get everybody on saving time, being the best that they can be. And yeah. So I'll be coming back to y'all with more videos on some of the little things that I do on making some stuff easier, saving time. And but the next video will be on the hardware for the balloon columns. So bye y'all, I'm out.